Hello everyone, welcome to Insightful Leadership, an initiative by Thoughts on Education by collegedunia.com. So today we are with Dr. Rajesh Bahuguna, Vice Chancellor of Uttaranchal University. Welcome sir. So your journey has been great throughout and I think it's been a phenomenal journey. So how it feels, you know, coming from a different background to education, how it's a change altogether?
Well, as you have already seen, initially I was in Indian Air Force and I served Indian Air Force for 15 years. And during that time itself, I was increasing my qualification also. So I did my PG in law from Jodhpur University and then subsequently doctorate from Kurukshetra University.
Okay.
So during that period itself, I was planning that after a minimum service, I will definitely go and serve the country as a teacher. So then I resigned after the minimum services which is required for Indian Air Force, that is 15 years. Then I joined DAV PG College as a lecturer of law.
Okay.
So what I feel, Both the services are quite different, but the one thing is very common which is required for both, that is discipline.
Right.
So the discipline and the planned and organized way of life which I have learned from Indian Air Force is always helpful to me here also and to my students and my subordinate whom I guide in that way. So it's very nice, excellent. I'm happy here. I'm satisfied with my work as a professor of law.
Right. Okay. So the next question is, the education system in India and other foreign countries are structured very differently. In your experience, what can an inbound student gain from studying here in Uttaranchal University?
That's a fine question. See, what I understand that there should be a combination of both. International pattern, which you call global, and the traditional Indian pattern. So in Uttaranchal University, you will find a unique blend of both the system, meaning thereby.
Okay.
At one place, you will have all those standard of education like online education, smart classrooms, and all other measures, latest teaching methodology, everything. But we never deviate from the effective classroom teaching. And in my opinion, it sometimes differ from course to course also. See, for example, if you take legal education, no doubt we have started and some institutions are following also online coaching, distance education, but a perfect lawyer, confident lawyer can be prepared in classroom and the well-equipped moot court setup which we have in our university. Similarly for other courses, like we have agriculture. So it's a traditional course, but the latest technology, latest innovations are to be coupled with, and when my student goes in the field, they grow onion of the size, big size, and they show me, sir, it is grown in our own field. So that is the practical education.
Right.
Similarly in engineering branch, when they go and sit in the R&D section, they say the government projects going on, research going on. So So it should be the, but I need to say, the combination of both.
Mm.
That's what we have a vision and we provide here in Uttarakhand University.
Right. And I do believe your point very well that, you know, post the lockdown scenes, we are seeing that, you know, there are few university colleges who are trying to adapt an online learning platform. But on the other hand, the practical knowledge that we can give to a student, that can be only done in a campus. Right. Okay. So moving on to our next question. So when you first came to Uttaranchal University, what was your vision for the university and how it has evolved over time and how far along in implementing that vision you are right now?
That's fine question. In fact, as I told you, I joined this university from the day one. But let me tell you, Uttaranchal University was established in the year of 2012-13. But seed of education was sown long back on 1st August 2002 when their first institution in the name of Law College Dehradun was established.
Mm-hmm.
And that at that point of time, we were affiliated to HNB Garhwal Central University.
Mm-hmm.
So that was the first institution when this group came into education line. So from there itself, we had a big vision in our mind.
Mm-hmm.
And the vision was to establish education institution which are with the at one time to fulfill the requirement of the society,
mm-hmm.
global standard, and at the same time affordable. So what I need to say, and another thing of ours is that we do not believe in long step one after another.
Right.
We want to take a step, establish ourselves, then take the next step,
mm-hmm.
which is evident from the fact. On 1st August 2002, we started Law College Dehradun. And as you know, LCD is among the top notch colleges of the country at present. So after establishing Law College Dehradun, we came up in 2006 with engineering college in the name of Uttaranchal Institute of Technology and Management College, Uttaranchal Institute of Management. When we established all these three institutions, we felt that there are certain reservations with affiliation with the government universities. And that was very practical. Everybody of this country will agree to that.
Mm-hmm.
That is, in government setup, you cannot plan. Why? Because, say for example, if I say I want to send my one of the students of law for internship in United Kingdom, right? So at that particular time, we will find that either examinations are postponed in government setup or something such type of happening and my entire planning fails.
Right.
So we thought of that we will establish our own university,
mm-hmm.
and that we did in 2012-13 with the merger of our three institutions, that is Law College Dehradun, Uttaranchal Institute of Technology, and Uttaranchal Institute of Management, and it became university. So we were discussing about our vision. The basic vision is establish one thing, then go for another. So like that, we are establishing. Now our entire focus is on to develop the research setup more and more to give our student job-oriented education. That is the vision.
That is really good, and I liked your vision that, you know, to make anything a big business or make, you know, achieve anything big in life, you have to achieve small milestones. And that is how I think Uttaranchal University is moving ahead. They achieved some small milestones in the future, and making it a university was might be a big dream for you as well, right? And now from university, you are planning to bring in a research center as well in the university. So I guess it's like taking baby steps and reaching a big target.
Exactly, got it.
Right. So the next question is, how does the curriculum of Uttaranchal University ensure the best practice of industry? So matlab, I would like to, you know, get your detailed view on this as we were talking about practical education as well, two questions back.
Okay, fine. So, see, curriculum of any course is the most important thing, and the curriculum only will ensure how are you going to build up the generation, right? So, what is the process? It in very detail. We have a well-established procedure of board of studies. Board of studies meaning thereby the how to design the curriculum. And top-ranked professors of the country are invited as a member of board of studies in different departments. And dean of that particular department is the chairperson of that.
Right.
So who are those taking part in framing or designing of the curriculum? Okay. One is the headship of the dean.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, he will see our requirement. Then the top-ranked subject experts from different university of the country.
Right.
Then the experts from industry.
Mm-hmm.
It may differ for the different course. Like if I want somebody for management, he will obviously from the management industry. If I want to pick the curriculum of law, it will be definitely from the Bar Council of India or any leading lawyer or law firms.
Mm-hmm.
One more thing I would like to bring to your knowledge,
mm-hmm.
that, see, now we understand there are series of avenues open for the graduates.
Mm-hmm.
And different avenues are open for different graduates.
Mm-hmm.
So what we are doing, say I will take the example of legal law course. So when, see, the law is one of the course, the syllabus of which is prescribed by Bar Council of India Central. So whether you study in Dehradun or you study in anywhere in this country, you will have to study the same subject, only with the difference. Only with the difference of optional subject, expertization, and what additional you can do. So see how I have planned. See, if somebody is joining me as a BA LLB honors,
mm-hmm.
so I understand that he will be having in his mind not only to practice in court of law, but at the same time either to join this country as a judicial officer or civil servant, right? So like for those who are coming for such reasons, I have taken political science as a major. See, now very important here, when you study, when you are taught 6 political science papers,
mm-hmm.
only thoughts you have been taught. So you can understand that theory of civil is prepared by default.
Right.
Similarly, I have taken care in all the other, what are the other options which should be open for my student? So certain things should be given to them which they take by default, not deliberately. See, they just do their course, and in law, if they are studying sociology also, so by default their pre-op civil services is going to be clear, because the entire syllabus according to that I have put in that. Similarly in management side, When I consult the industry, what you want?
Mm-hmm.
I'm regularly in touch with the top rank industry and our recruiters. And I ask them always, what is your requirement? If they want ki certain particular thing is to be taught them, I can take crash course also.
Mm-hmm.
I have well equipped faculty members with me, and sometimes we are calling the people from industry also to train my students for a particular course. So this is how we design the course, how we implement it. And
okay. So moving ahead, so you know, there are students who would like to know more about your university and the new initiatives that you are having, which you know, you might be totally different from other universities existing in India. So can you just throw some light on that as well?
Sure. See, any student or even any parents or any gentleman, first of all, in today's scenario, they want how is the atmosphere of the place where I am going to send my students.
Right.
This is first thing, this question may be tossing in the mind of everyone, including you and me.
Exactly.
So, Uttaranchal University is situated at a place which is almost environmental atmosphere. Very neat and clean, green campus amongst the hills of Uttarakhand. Right? First thing. Secondary thing, which one you want to know about the university, that almost the complete education is under single roof. Taking a start from law, undergraduate, diploma course, postgraduate, doctorate. The entire education is completely under the single roof. How it benefits the student? It benefits the student in the way, even if the student is of UG, so when he sees the atmosphere how the research is going on in my institution, then he picks up certain things. See, I take it in this way. Okay. See, if I am an advocate, senior advocate, fine, and I have practice of 20 years. So my son, who is of 30 years, he will have experience of 20 years by default. His experience will start from 20 years. So when under the single roof, doctorates are also researching, PG classes are also doing, research is going on, they have the interaction, everything, it benefits them in a different way. This is one thing. Second thing, which comes into a mind of any student and you would like to know, that is the placement of any university.
Right.
So we have a well-established placement cell in our university. See, placement is not entirely the work of any university, I believe, very honestly. This is the process where a student as well as institution both work together for a certain aim, and even on certain occasion parents are also responsible to take it up. So in that way, when placement cell asks them, they will give them a particular training as per the requirement of industry. They will give them personality development courses, and they will make them well equipped to face the interview. That is the duty of our placement cell. Now their second duty is to arrange the campus. Arrange the campus as on date. During the entire country, the pattern which is going on is campus placement also, referral also, and interviews also. There are different ways. So placement cell is updated whether they can arrange campus here, full campus here, or send the trained people for the interview to the different companies where we have tie up. So if we take the example of this year, last year only, so 70 on-campus and off-campus placement drive have been conducted here. And out of this, the result is 560 students got placement with 641 offer letters. And the highest placement offer was 15 lakh per annum. And 33 students received package of 12.4 LPA. While around 237 students were offered package of 3.0 LPA. And everything is with transparency put up on our website. We do not have any habit of claiming without proof, right? Their audio, video, recording, everything is placed there. This is one thing of the placement. Now, I understand that other than this corporate placement, what I have planned? I have planned for, like, we have the student of law. We have 1900 plus student on board of law. So, what I have planned for them? See, we have a competitive cell. This is very, very best practice and unique practice you won't find sometime. See how, and this is the way how I am connected with the student also all the time. We have a competitive cell in our institution, Law College Dehradun, and in which every day one paper will go to the student. See, for example, in first year, he has been taught constitution and talks. So, second year onward, he will receive every day one paper of constitution, next day answer of that.
Okay.
So, from the day one, I am preparing him for the judicial services or civil services.
Right.
And result is now 50 students of Law College Dehradun have become judges.
That is very nice.
One is in, three are working in, one is in Indian Army, one is in Indian Navy, as judge, advocate, journals also they are working. So, and when teaching them, six faculty have also achieved as a judge in higher judicial services. That is the added benefit to them because they are taking up care of the competitive set. So, corporate sector also and government sector also, because you know, for this competitive and everything, this is not a thing which can be done overnight. One has to plan from day one. So, right. This is how we are planning for my student to become a judicial officer or in other branches to join the industry. Mm-hmm. This is one point, placement. Mm-hmm. And another point, which a very serious student would like to know. We have a well-established research and development section here. So, our R&D is working on the projects. Government projects which cost in crores. So, what is the result? During last 2 years, we have filed 26 patents. That is the achievement. And out of which 18 have already been placed. So, this is what is the research atmosphere and which I have endeavoring to continue enhance the research. Another thing which a student would like to know, it is not only the classroom study or lab or moot court or this and that. Beyond that, I believe the students are full with energy, right?
Yes.
So, their energy is to be channelized in a right direction. If you are failed to channelize their energy, there will be agitation, there will be union body, there will be so many other things disrupting. So, what we have done? We have strong student bodies and clubs. Say, for example, Youth Parliament Society. You will be very happy to know, during last 10 days, 10 top ranked speakers of the country have spoken on this platform. So certain student I have directed towards the Youth Parliament Society. And I also believe it is our responsibility to give good gentlemen to the society. When a student of Youth Parliament Society who has already practiced how to introduce bill in parliament, how to introduce bill in the legislative assembly, when he himself become a legislator, you can understand that what will be the result of that. I remember one of my students, he was opposition leader in Youth Parliament, and immediately after passing out, he became MLA in Assembly of Uttar Pradesh. And he brought me, "Sir, what I have learned during Parliament, I am applying to that." That is the achievement. But I mean to say, and debating society, very strong debating society, every year national debate is being organized. And the society is grooming my student for that. Then we have Moot Court Society. Every year, everybody know LCD and CS is famous in the country. Every month, every year in the month of October on constitutional law is organized. This is student body, then Green Society, then Legal Aid Center, and we have adopted villages also. This is why I am telling you, the student, other than the study, they want to engage themselves on some other field also, that we are providing. And these student bodies, after they groom the students, they are bringing laureates to the university. And I can count you the series of awards and achievement of the students. Sometimes top ranked debates have been green. And when they leave the cup, I feel we are happy and we have achieved the aim of that. So these are a few things what students would like to.
Very nice, sir. Great vision, sir. Great vision. So moving ahead, so as the Vice Chancellor of the university, what do you think are your roles and responsibilities towards the university and the students?
Okay, you're talking about my roles and responsibilities.
Yes, sir.
Fine. That is very, 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 very relevant question you have asked. See, what I think, a Vice Chancellor of a university is a guardian of the university. Mm-hmm. He is not only the academic head, he is also the administrative head also of the university. Mm-hmm. And the students, parents, employees of all level, as well as the faculty member, see towards him. And for that, I will share you and my viewer only one thing. I feel his position is like a head of the family in undivided Hindu family. The head of your family, he never say to his son or daughter, "Do not do this." Mm-hmm. Say, "You should not do this." And if the head of the family has his own vision, dignity and character, his advice will be order to all the family members.
Right.
Got my point? Right, so sir. This is the position. Not that I should say to my employee, "You will not do this." Only Isara. They should understand from my conduct that what our head wants. If they are following that, I'm a successful leader.
Right.
I always take classes. Teaching is my passion. Even being a dean, I have been taking 3 classes every day. And that is one way how I am connected with the students also.
Right.
Okay. So it's a only one role. Role of a model, mentor, guardian. Right.
Right. Really nice, sir. So, would you like to give you any insights on how your university could be more welcoming to students of different races or economic backgrounds?
That is very contemporary question in today's scenario. I'm very happy that you have asked this question and should be asked to have the institution. Very good question. Fine. See, we are sometimes claiming, I don't want to name, there are so many institutions, they claim that we have this facility, we have that facility. And an abnormal amount is being charged for that. For whom you are giving this facility? For a class only, for a handful people only. But the maximum people of this country, they are below the poverty line. Sometimes middle class. So can they think of paying fees in lakhs and lakhs? No. They are bound to either go to the institution where they didn't want or to leave their education. The best part of it, you will not see many advertisement of Uttaranchal University. It is only mouth publicity. We save a lot of money, and you will be happy to know it, where we utilize that crores and crores saved from the advertisement. That is in our fee structure. We work for the common man. We work for them, those who cannot afford. Such institutions who claim to be world class, and what is the ground reality you are coach? So we are providing them everything within the affordable class. It is my own experience I would like to share with you. In law, mass communication, and there are certain fields where you will find the student from the common background and successful people. But when they come to my institutions, I have so many scholarship for them. Last year we have distributed scholarship more than 2 crores. We have in our mind that what we can do to the downtrodden people. What we can do to deprived people, what we can give to the students, those who are bright students but not in a position to pay. So we have scholarships. If you have 90%, if you have 90% and above marks in your courses, you get certain percentage, then 80%. Even you have 60% marks, you get a scholarship. That is what the students become eligible to enter in this institution. One thing. Secondary thing, this institution is in the state of Uttarakhand. So what we are doing for the state? We have decided 26% discount in fees to all the students of Uttarakhand. That is what we are giving in all the courses. Right from the day one we started our university here. Secondary thing, to give salute to our defense forces, whether it is Army, Navy, Air Force or paramilitary classes for forces, we are also giving them discount in the fees. Right. Then if you are studying in our university and your sister, brother comes, then also. So what we want, it's by this way, at one place we are just doing something for the cause of society, one thing, and we are creating a good bonding. And the student whom we have helped today, he becomes our proud alumni sometime, and he is always ready to help us. Right. It helps us a lot. So this is what we are doing for that.
Right. So this is really great, sir, really great. So, how do you tend to establish a healthy environment in your university?
Okay, fine. See, healthy environment, when you say it, it's not only one thing, it's a combination of so many things. It's a combination of so many things.
Right.
See, in a campus, if you have totally timing for study, this and that, so this will be the one way. If you are given good education in classroom, everything, but to make an healthy environment of the campus, you need sports facility. So what we do, there's a very good sports ground. They play different indoor and outdoor games, basketball ground, volleyball grounds, crickets, and all every ground. That is a sport. Then there are certain youth now, they want to go in gym. So we have a very good gym facility, a very advanced gym. They can go there. Besides this, but we have learned regularly the cultural program.
Right.
See, somebody is not in sport, sometimes in sport, but he's very good in culture. He's a singer, he's a dancer.
Right.
So we have the cultural committee has different subcommittees, like pop dance committee. Okay, like English dance and other dances. So students are, I told you in the very beginning, it is how you channelize the energy. How you channelize that energy. So it all together makes the healthy atmosphere in the campus. Besides this, I would like to share one more. See, the youth is such an age where it is not only institution will make them bright. They students as well as their parents. So we are in touch with the parents also, because we have a well-established ERP system here. And your parent who is sitting far away is able to see your progress from here. One time it looked to us that, oh, my father will also come to know, but I understand, I believe, at this age, we must understand that we all together, Guru, Mata Pita, and student, when we all three work together, then only we will achieve success. So
right.
We establish such a healthy atmosphere.
Right, sir. So, what do you think, and what should be the university's top priority over next 10 years for students?
Pardon?
So, what do you think, and what should be the university's top priority over next 10 years?
Okay, fine. The top priority, if you count to me, now I will share one thing to review. And very practical thing with my own experience and experience of the scholars whom I study and whom I listen. First of all, we can plan for 10 year, 20 year or whatever the years be. But my dear friend, it is time, place and circumstances which decide the thing. You have seen last 3 months, the entire world is changed.
Right, sir.
But at the same time, we cannot sit idly that we will stop here. Okay, so what I have planned that in coming years, I will develop the infrastructure in such a way so that we can have at least 25% of the classes online perfectly. One thing I have decided. Secondary thing I have decided, and which we are regularly doing, what is the demand of the industry? What is the demand of the market? What they want? We are developing such course for the forthcoming years. Right? So that we can attracting one thing, but so that we can give the best product to the country. That is my planning for the 4KM. That's why I told you, time, place and circumstances will decide what we do.
Right, sir. Very good. Very nice, sir. So, coming to our last question, so any suggestions and, you know, any your views which you would like to share with the current youth and the aspiring students?
Okay, so if youth include other than students, then I will say separately, but this my suggestion is only for the students. Okay, see, sometime what we feel and some parents and some advisor advise that you open 4-5 door always, so that if you are not selected here, you go here. Okay. I am of the opinion, whenever you are doing a particular thing, devote 100% to that only. And what is that? I will share one incident of one comrade. He was taking a meeting of students. So they asked them, ki, what is our duty? So he saw to his front, there was hundred of students. He said, the duty of a student is to study. He turned to right, see the student and say, duty of a student is to study. Back turn, left turn, and then comes the case, only duty of a student is to study. If somebody says, I am doing politics, I am doing this, I am learning this, you are deviating yourself.
No.
Give your 100% to the cause you are meant for. It happened only when you deviate yourself in some other activities.
Right.
So your focus should be on study and keep it in mind, 100% you will have success in your goal.
Right. Thank you so much, Dr. Rajesh. It was a really insightful interview for me, and it will be equally insightful for the students who will be watching it. So everyone, this was Professor Dr. Rajesh Bahugunam, Vice Chancellor, Uttaranchal University. Thank you so much for speaking with us, sir. Thank you so much.